Hi there. So this first introduction exercise, I'd like you to copy along on these exercises. These are just sort of the most basic simple forms. A little bit later, we're going to talk about how to modify these simple forms into more complex shapes, like things with like a funnel shape attached to it, or a hollowed out shape that like you might use for a bowl. But to start with, we're just going to do the most basic shapes. We're going to start with a sphere, and I think for the sphere we'll just kind of treat more or less, we won't worry too much about tilting it very much, but I do want you to find the midpoint. So I'd like you to draw a center line through the middle, and I also want you to find the midpoint so that we can get the cross contour lines wrapping around it in both directions. So we're going to have sort of a north pole and a south pole, and then we're going to have the equator and other latitude lines wrapping around. So I'm going to just use the term longitude for any lines that run the length of the object, that run along the long axis of the object. And with a ball, it's hard to tell, but with longer shapes, it'll be more obvious. And then we're going to use latitude to describe cross contours that are going to be wrapping around the width of the object. So to start with, we'll just kind of keep this real simple. We'll pretend that the north pole is right there at the outer contour of the circle, and the south pole is here at the bottom. And then we're just going to draw some simple longitude lines. So what I'd like you to do is, we've already got one longitude line in here, the one that's like right in the middle of the ball. And this outer contour actually is kind of like a cross contour line too at the perimeter of the ball. And what I'd like you to do is add another one that's halfway between the straight line and the curved line. So it's going to be not as curved as the outer contour of the ball and not as straight as the center one. So just do your best to kind of lightly scribe in a division there. So again, this is not as, it's not describing a three-dimensional form as well as it could if we had tipped it a little bit so we could see down at the North Pole a little bit more, which we'll do later. But just to kind of keep the exercise moving, we'll do the simpler version of it right now. And then let's pretend that instead of having the equator being straight across, let's add a little bit of curve there just so we can start to imagine this ball as being a three-dimensional round ball. So use a very light ellipse. We're going to darken the front so it starts to take on some volume. You can make the back edge dotted if you want to, or just use a really light touch so that it doesn't confuse the viewer. And then we're going to add a couple more. So let's add another ellipse. Try to keep your ellipse proportions pretty close to the one you just drew so that we're being consistent on kind of what our eye level appears to be. And again, keep the back side a little bit lighter. And then you could add as many lines in between there as you want. So additional longitude lines that are in here, you know, are going to be halfway between the lines that are on either side of them. And you could add more ellipses as we get closer to the North Pole and the South Pole. So that's kind of a real basic spherical form. If you were to do a pyramidal or a cone, a conical form, you would start with an ellipse. So whatever the base of your cone looks like, find the midpoint. So just kind of estimate what's the middle of that and go up as high as you want for the shape of your cone. And that's just a matter of connecting, you know, those edges. And we'll darken in the front edge. Again, try to make your ellipse as smooth and precise as you can. And then you could add a few more lines in between. So these would just be kind of like our longitude lines all leading to the tip of that shape. Now let's pretend that we're tipping the cone up. Right now we're looking down on the cone, but if you wanted to kind of change your vantage point on it, what we could do is we could darken the whole ellipse here so that now we're looking at the bottom of the cone, and if we erase those few little guidelines that are in there, we can suggest a flat surface. So a nice way to suggest a real abrupt plane change like that, where we go from, you know, one angle to another, is on a flat plane like this. If you can identify where the center of that plane is and just have all of the lines head straight for that point and then extend beyond it. So any lines coming in from the edges, you could just bring them right through the middle. We could even imagine this one on the front is going through the middle across the back too. So that creates flat plane there. And if we use better line weight variation, we could even tell which edge of the cone is closer to the viewer. So again, all these lines just aim toward the midpoint. And we could lighten this back edge a little bit if we wanted to feel farther away. So using atmospheric perspective to lighten that a little bit. All right, so that's another real simple shape. We do still probably need to add a few little ellipses. Try to keep in mind the shape of that ellipse, and we're going to make a few further up on the cone. It shouldn't be getting flatter. If anything, they would be getting a little bit rounder. So you can darken in. If you darken in the upper part of that, it's really going to feel like we're looking up underneath that cone shape. All right, let's try a wedge of cheese. So again, we've got kind of the basic simple ellipse again. The one at the bottom you might make a tiny bit rounder if you want to try to play around with perspective and eye level. And let's go ahead and darken in a little bit this top ellipse. We're going to imagine this is a wheel of cheese that we're going to cut a slice out of. So again, it's going to be important to kind of find the center point of our two ellipses. We can put a little crosshair in each one of those so we can kind of imagine where the center of that ellipse is. And then let's figure out if we were to cut a wedge of that cheese, or if it's cake, cutting a wedge out, let's kind of make it slice off to the side so we can get a more descriptive sense of perspective on there. So we've got, we can kind of figure out where the cut would touch the surface here. What's a little trickier is figuring out where, what to do with this leftover bit at the bottom here. But since we've imagined this as a transparent wedge of cheese, we can know exactly where the center of that base ellipse is and put a dot there too. And then it's just a matter of connecting these two bottom parts of the cut to the bottom part of the wheel so that, again, if you drew it transparently, we'd have another little wedge that cuts in there. And it might need to even be a little bit higher. It looks like it's not quite angled. But anyway, we'll just darken that in to create this illusion of a wedge of cheese. And if it were a double layer cake, you could even do that too. So let's say you add one more ellipse to suggest where the two layers of the cake meet. And you could even have the frosting show in the middle there too, as if it were. And if you want to add a little bit of hatching, you can do that as a cross contour line too to suggest shadow, but try to keep it orienting the same way that that plane is running so that the shading helps reinforce that sense of volume. All right, the trickiest form, it's not super tricky, but I'm going to just turn this over so that I can draw a little bit closer to myself, is going to be a form that bends in space. So we're going to have a piece of elbow macaroni that we're going to be drawing here. And to start with, I just want you to draw two lines. Try to keep them about the same distance apart from one another if you can. So it's almost like a rainbow that we're drawing. And we're going to draw a center line. This will become the axis line that runs down the middle of that macaroni. So you can draw the ends. What I'd like you to do is kind of think of this as sort of a fan shape. So one end of it's going to be angled out one way, one's going to be angled out the other way, and then in the middle we'll have a straight line. And we're going to be able to see both ends of the macaroni. So go ahead and draw in an ellipse at both sides. And let's even make it feel like it's hollow. So we're going to add another ellipse. That one was not drawn very well, but inside the first one to show the thickness of the pasta. All right, so we've got this line as our indicator for how curved the cross contours are going to be on this end. And we've got this line now going the other direction that shows how curved the cross contours need to be at this end. But in the middle, it needs to transition. So we have to be able to switch from a curve going this way. It'll get straighter and straighter, and then it starts to curve the other way. So what I like to do is, if we could really see a string or something wrapped around that macaroni right in the middle, it would just be a straight line from our point of view. But as we get closer to the ends, the curve becomes more apparent. So halfway between a perfectly straight line and this rounded ellipse is going to be an ellipse that's half as wide as this one. So it's not going to be quite as fat. It's only going to be half of that width. So you could just take your skewer or your pencil and estimate what half of that distance is going to be and center that on our axis line here. And then darken in. Again, make sure you're making it curve the right way. It's got to curve the same way that this end curves. It's just getting a little bit flatter. And as we get even closer, you might just keep subdividing. So this ellipse that's halfway between the straight line and this one needs to be, you know, halfway, only half as wide as that one, which is half as wide as this one, you know. So anyway, try to be as consistent as you can with them getting a little bit rounder as we go. You don't want to have super curved ones and then right next to a straight one. And you do the same thing on the other side. You're just kind of reversing those proportions. So whatever half of this one ended up being, I want to center that here and lightly sketch in and then darken the front edge. But do think about that back edge, because without that, it's hard to judge if your ellipses are nice and symmetrical. And then this one will be flatter. All right, we've got macaroni. We've got the latitude lines that are wrapping around the width of it. We want to add a few longitude lines, so we can use our center line as one of those. And then let's add a couple more as we get closer to the edge. It looks pretty cool if you can make the lines get closer and closer together as you get toward the edge, because then it really feels like those planes are rolling away from us and we're seeing more and more lines foreshortened as we get toward the edges there. All right, now when these lines get to the end, suddenly there's an angle change. So those lines need to head toward the center line and then cross over. So the part, we're only drawing the lines on the part that is the end of the pasta. We're not putting it in the hole. So you can leave that part light still. But each one of these lines should lead toward the midpoint and then extend across it to the other side of the macaroni. In the middle, it may just be a straight line. And then these that hit at the corner, kind of think about where that center of that ellipse might be and try to get all your lines to align with that. There we go. And then if you wanted to draw the surface of the inside of the noodle, you got to think, okay, that inside tube is a little bit narrower, so the curves in there need to be a little bit smaller than the ones that are on the outside of the object. And again, you're kind of using that first curve as your guide for how curved to make the other ones nearby. And then we could also maybe have some lines that run the length of the tube inside there too to suggest shading, but they are also cross contour, so it's fine to put those in. So we've got macaroni shape as well. So I'd like you to draw all four of these shapes for me and submit it as one of your homework assignments, and then you'll do a longer drawing where you are drawing. These are just theoretical drawings that you're drawing from your imagination, but then for your longer drawing, you're going to be choosing a real-life object, a piece of fruit, or a man-made object that fits kind of this assignment well, and you're going to be drawing a very large drawing with a lot of line weight variation and putting all those cross contours in for me, running the length and the width of the object, and submitting a photo of your fruit as well as the finished drawing. Good luck. Let me know if you have any questions. I'm glad to help you if you've got a special situation that I didn't cover in the demo. Thank you.